हेलो हेलो माइक टेस्ट। हेलो गाइस, आई एम ऋत्विक दशोरा एंड आई एम बैक विद अ न्यू वीडियो एंड सम न्यू लर्निंग्स। इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू नो हाउ टू डाउनलोड हिस्टोरिकल स्टॉक डेटा इन पाइथन यूजिंग polygon.io फॉर फ्री, then you're at the right place. Today we will use polygon.io API to build a Python model which will output historical stock data in a pandas data frame. It can be used to do things like financial analysis, like ratio analysis, or just to be updated on any particular stock. You also know there can be a million applications of any financial data. So before we start building this model, if you are new around here on this channel, I turn you into a successful financial programmer. Here I upload videos related to topics such as trading bots, using highly valuable finance APIs, implementation of AI in finance, etc., etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, I offer an amazing gift to all my lovely subscribers. You'll very soon get to know what is the gift. Also, if you want me to cover more videos on polygon.io API, like making a trading bot using a polygon.io, etc., then just hit a like on this video. If it crosses 200 likes, then I'll be considering more videos on the same API. So are you ready? Let's start. So the topics that we'll cover today is we'll first see what is polygon.io. Actually, I covered this in my last videos as well, in which I have mentioned how to extract stock news in Python using polygon.io and getting the comparable companies list in Python. You can click on this I button to watch those video. And actually, there's a playlist that I'm making on polygon.io, and this is the third video of that playlist. Then we will see how to get a free API key of polygon.io. We'll construct the API URL to get the data. Then we'll use the requests library to extract the financials data. As I already mentioned, this is a playlist, and so let's see what are the upcoming videos. The first two videos I've already covered. This is the third video, that is getting the financials of any particular company. The fourth video will be on the stock split, stock dividend information, and the fifth video will be that we'll make a basic screener of top gainers and top losers. This entire playlist is in the iBook. I've already covered a lot of videos on extracting company financials using different APIs like Alpha Vantage, Wolf Data, IEX Cloud, Bloomberg in Python, etc., etc. You can click here to watch all those videos. Polygon.io is a financial data provider. You can see that it provides data related to stocks, forex, crypto, etc. And then very soon they are planning to launch options data as well, and I'm very excited about that as well. You can get your free API by clicking here and then just making an account over there. After that, this will be the window that you'll be having in front of you. You can see that there are two types of documentation, which is RESTful docs and WebSockets. So the RESTful docs, in that you can see that all the green dots are actually the free APIs, and all the purple dots or blue dots are actually covered under the paid subscription. All these videos are for the free usage of polygon.io. In future, if I get more money on Patreon or if I get a brand deal with polygon.io, I'll cover these topics as well. As far as WebSocket is concerned, everything over there is covered under the paid subscription. And you might remember I have covered a video on WebSocket client where we extracted real-time Bitcoin or any particular crypto data in Python. You can click here on this I button to watch that video. Going back to the dashboard, you can see that on left hand side we have API keys. This is the default API key which is allocated to me. If you click here, you can copy, and also if you click on the API, you can click on edit to regenerate this API, which I will do after recording this video for sure, because I want you guys to have your own API key. In the RESTful docs, today we will cover the stock financials. Clicking it here, you can see a lot of things. If I run query, all the financials of Apple is in front of you. So let me just copy this URL and paste it on the Google Colab Python platform. API URL is equal to this. And there's one more thing actually. On the same code, I have written the code for extracting the stock news and getting the comparable companies list. And this code will be actually saved in my Google Drive, which is the gift to all my lovely subscribers. I'll tell you in this video how to get a free access of my Google Drive very soon. This is the API URL that we'll be using for to extract the stock financials. Let me make it a bit user friendly. So API is equal to, let me paste it here and convert it into F string and change it to API. Second thing that I can do is the ticker is Apple here, and I can change this to ticker. The third thing is the limit. Limit is the number of columns that it will generate in that particular pandas data frame. So here it's just 5. Let me just write 70 because I've tried it and it has given me a lot of columns, and it's better to get as much as information for free as possible. So changing it to limit. Perfect. So let's run this cell, and then API URL is this thing. Let's copy this URL and paste it on the browser. You can see that all this information is now available. Now our task is to extract this information in Python, and for that we will be using requests library. Import requests, and then data is equal to requests dot get, and then API URL dot json. If I run data, I've got all the financials of Apple, and you can see that I'm only interested in results. So if I write it like this, there are two options that are available to me: results and status. I'm not interested in status because status is okay, which is not a useful information to me. So results is this. If I run this, I've got all the important information using results. Now it's better to make a data frame because it's hard, very difficult to analyze a dictionary. So import pandas as pd. Pandas is the library that is used for making data frames or any sort of data manipulation. It's highly valuable library in finance actually. So let me convert it into df is equal to pd dot data frame, and then data results. If I run df, then I would get a data frame like this, and you can see that all the financial statements lines are in the column. So I'll have to transpose this data. So statement is equal to df dot t. If I run statement, I would get the transpose version, which is actually all these lines headers are in the rows. Now I'll have to manipulate this data frame a bit to get to the final data frame. The speciality of polygon.io is that it outputs all the financial data in just one data frame. So we don't need to think about income statement, balance sheet, cash flow statement, or any other financial statements data separately. Everything is in just one data frame. Now, for a few people, it's a good functionality. For a few people, it's not. But in my opinion, I think I like it because I have all the information in just one data frame. I know there are many rows, like 111 rows in just one data frame, but sometimes it's very, very useful to refer to just one data frame for any further analysis. I'm interested to know your opinion. Do you like this functionality? Also, if you know any other finance API that you use for your personal use, just mention in the comment box. In future, maybe I'll try to cover all of them. So in this data frame, I am only interested in yearly annualized data. We can also extract the quarterly data, but let's take the yearly data first and then we'll work on the quarterly data. So we'll have to do some manipulation here. And for this, let me just put the period in the column header such that it will be very easy to scoop out this yearly annualized data from this data frame. It can be done like this: statement dot columns is equal to list of statement dot lock, and then let's just copy period and paste it here. If I run statement, okay, so I should be lock. If I run statement, you can see that all of them are in the column headers. Now I'm only interested in YA, so it will be an statement, which represents annual statement, is equal to statement and then YA. If I run an state, it has given me all the year annualized data for the dates of 2019 December, 2018 December, 2017 December, and 2016 December. They have not yet updated 2020 December for some reason, but I'm quite sure they will do it very soon. So this is the last 4 years data, annualized data of Apple. So let me create one more variable, which is annual state final. And actually I'm only interested in the rows after these many rows because these are not the financial data. So which will be an state, and then it will be from 5. Should be like this, from 5. If I run and state fin, still it should be from 6. Perfect. We are now getting very close to get the final data. I'll have to change the column headers as well. It should be the calendar date. So dot columns is equal to, let me just copy this and paste it here, and it should be the calendar dates. So pasting it here. Let's see what is an state fin. Okay, so I have made some, oh sorry, it should be an state. Okay, so we have got all the dates in the column headers and all the important financial lines in the row header, and I think this is the final data frame that we can use for further analysis. Similarly, for this is the annualized data for Apple. We can do it for quarterly data as well. If I just copy all these things and paste it like this and then change it to Q state, this should be quarterly, which is Q. This will be also Q. Let me change it to all quarterly data, Q and Q. If I run this cell, there's a lot of information which is not available, so it's better to drop out all these rows. So Q find state fin dot drop NA in place is equal to true. The in place is equal to true is used to make it permanent. So yeah, running this cell, you can see that you have got all the quarterly data for last 4 years. It starts from 2020 March, and then we can get it till 2016 June. So this is how we can extract the stock financials of annual and quarterly data using polygon.io in Python. Wait, before you leave, we forgot the gift, right? So this code will be saved in my Google Drive, and you can get a free access of my Google Drive by subscribing to my YouTube channel and then clicking on access to my Google Drive button. Just follow some steps over there, and on that Google form you can just provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address to provide a free access of my Google Drive. And this service is only available to all my subscribers and everyone who have followed all the steps. Also, not just this code, there are many more codes that are saved on my Google Drive, and I bet you that you won't find all those material anywhere else on YouTube or internet. If you like this educational video, then you can support me on Patreon. The link is in the description box. On Patreon, you can see that there are different benefits for different levels. There are 6 levels over there, and for all these levels you can see there are different type of posts that I do on Patreon. Your contribution means a lot to me because it keeps me motivated to work harder and to pay some of the financial APIs that I'll be covering very soon on this YouTube channel. I have many plans for this YouTube channel, and for this I need your support. I assure you that you have just seen the trailer. The movie is yet to come. The Patreon link is in the description box. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you can see how I use WebSocket to extract real-time Bitcoin prices in Python. And over there you can see this playlist, which is a playlist on polygon.io. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much.